Hi guys, today I'm going to be replacing the front impact crash sensors on this 2017 Honda Accord, which I got accidented. If you follow this channel, you would know I started a series on the restoration of this 2017 Honda Accord, which was involved in a front collision and had the steering wheel airbag deployed. I've done the bodywork, fixed the airbag, and now I'm replacing the crash sensor. I'll cover the function and location of crash sensors in general before I go on to replace the actual part in this vehicle. Now let's get this. Replacing crash sensors is sometimes required after an accident, especially if they are physically damaged or if your manufacturer states that the crash sensors should be replaced after an accident. Although I don't have a code for the front crash sensors, I'm replacing this just as a precaution. While getting this car, I also bought the crash sensors just in case. I was anticipating that it could have been damaged. As you can see here, I have a scan result of a similar car which was involved in an accident. There's a code for the front crash sensor. The SIRS module or ECU relies on crash sensors to sense sudden deceleration in movement and thus deploy the appropriate airbag. The steering wheel, knee and passenger airbags rely on the front crash sensor, while the side curtains and the seat airbags rely on the side impact sensors, which are typically hidden under the panel of the doors in cars that are equipped with side airbags. Front crash sensors are usually located in the front of the vehicle. For this vehicle, they are beneath this plastic trim just in front of the AC condenser, and we're going to get to it. But as you can see on this 2008 Toyota Corolla, they are located in plain sight right here. You can always identify crash sensors by the yellow connectors. All vehicle manufacturers use yellow to code the connectors for all SRS components.
Tools you're going to need: size 10 wrench for taking out the negative terminal of the battery, clip remover tool, T30 Torx wrench. The sensors are held by T30 Torx screws.
So the first thing you want to do is to disable the SRS system, and to do that you disconnect the negative terminal of the battery. Allow it to stay for at least 3 minutes. Negative terminal off. Let's get to the crash sensors and replace them. We'll start by removing these clips. 1, 2, 3, and 4. And this comes out. In a bit to gain a bit more room, we'll also remove this clip here and also free up this clip for the chrome piece on the left side, as well as on the right side. This will give you much needed room to remove the crash sensors.
With those removed, you have a bit more leverage to pull this back a bit. Crash sensors are right here. That's the one for the right. The one for the left is here as well, just in front of the AC condenser, which you can just about see there. And I'll give you a close-up shot.
And that's the crash sensor right there. Not the best location to work in. As you can see, the screw holding it is quite rusted. You might need a bit of WD-40 if it starts proving difficult.
So finally, this is out. Screw was really rusted. So once you get it out, to remove the connector, I'm just wedging it against the horn here. Then you pull back this piece. A fair amount of tension on this. And then as you pull it back, you pull on the sensor itself. That's all the way. Then you pull back. And that's it. That's the part number right there. So I just go ahead to replace the new one. To put in the new sensor, same thing, you have to pull this back again. So get it fitted, pull this back. I'm pushing the new sensor and it goes in. There's this aligning bump here, which goes in here. Sorry for my lighting. The screw itself goes in there.
By the way, make sure you stay tuned for the next video in this series, where we're going to be pulling out the SRS module, clearing the crash data, and finally turning off this annoying airbag light.
Every other thing is in reverse. Fit this in.
But I'll just like to show you something when you're refitting this wing tip. You'll notice that this is not lapping correctly, and that's because...
So that piece needs to go in here.
So what you do to get it to lap is you pull back, so that piece goes under and then it laps. And you go ahead to secure with the push clips. That's it guys, thanks very much for watching. Catch you on the next one. Cheers.